first video, I want to take a look at some more scenic items. And for this video, we're going to concentrate on the low relief buildings. Now, low relief buildings, for those of you that don't know, is basically a building that sits on your back seam, as you see here. And this is only about 10 millimeters, 50 millimeters deep from front to back. So it's to give you the impression of a much bigger building, so that it would blend into your back scene. For the back scene here, we've used a sky back scene, which I'll put a link to all these the items you'll see in the video down below. So we're going to add in some more of these low relief buildings along the back here. Now, these low relief buildings that you're going to see are from modelrailwayscenery.com and its sister company scalemodelscenery.co.uk. I shall place the links down below. Now, the one you see here, this is one of the pre-printed versions, so it comes with everything you need. Also available as a download kit version, so it's a case of you go on the website, you click purchase, and then you get given a link. You click on the link and basically you download the kit as a PDF file to wherever you want to store your download files on your computer, and then a case of opening the file and then printing off. You use photo paper around about 100-102 GSM paper. Again, I'll put a link down below as to the ones that photo paper that I use. So as you can see here, this is one of the pre-printed ones, and this is the low relief office block, which we're going to either put either to the right or the left hand side. So it comes with all the photo textured paper, all the guide cutting out templates, and the card as well. On the download versions, you could use like a cereal packet card and stuff like that, so it makes good use for recycling. Now, on the download version, we're going to be building this kit for this video. Now, I've printed off basically the instructions in black and white, so for when you get the download, basically you get a bit of information about the kit, as you can see here. It lists sort of the tools and the glue and stuff that you need, and the various papers and the card, and then it runs through the instructions. The instructions are very clear. Obviously, on the file that you download, all these pictures will be in colour. As I say, I printed these off in black and white, but it runs with instructions. It runs through every step of the way on how to build the kit. These are your templates. So basically, you will glue these onto your card that you're going to use. And then for the textures layers that you see on here, this kit, basically there's two. So it's a case of you cut these out for the instructions and you stick them down over the top of the card. Okay. It also comes with a selection of like alternative fire exit doors, stuff like that, so yeah, there's plenty of scope for customization. And as you can see here, it also comes with several different fictitious companies, two air conditioning units, as you can see here, like these two that's made up on there, a selection of health and safety signs that you see underneath, sort of like factories and industrial units, and your CCTV cameras, so your drain pipes, and so with the roofing. So as I say, we'll run through how we'll build this kit in the next clip onwards to follow. So the tools you'll need for doing these download kits, or the pre-printed ones, is first of all the trusty old cutting mat, a steel ruler, craft knife, and would recommend possibly having a pack of spare blades, because you can soon blunt these if you're cutting through a fair amount of card. A decent pair of scissors. For the glues, something like Pritstick or equivalent, and this is the Morrison's own version. Like Bostick or equivalent Yoohoo glue. And one of the other main glues I would recommend is this Deluxe Materials Row Kit Card Glue. This is bang on this stuff, and I'll put a link down below. Now, the other thing I think on is the base layer, the card. If you're not sure what card to go for, Scale Model Scenery, they also sell packs of the grey foam board card. And again, I'll put a link down below so where you can get it from. Right, let's crack on with the build. So the first thing we do on this now is that we will glue the template sheet onto the grey foam board, and we'll use the Pritstick or equivalent. So the first job is with your Pritstick or glue stick is to give your sheet of card a coating of glue. Yeah, that looks good to me. And next we stick the template sheet on, so we'll just try and make sure this is square to the edges. And then just gently smooth out, make sure there's no air bubbles or wrinkles. And as you can see here, this is one of the ones we've just done a couple of minutes ago. So we'll allow it to dry for a couple of minutes, and we'll then cut these pieces out. So now that the glue's dried a bit, we'll cut out the main base wall layer template. So it's just then a case of, with your steel ruler, line that across the edge, and very carefully, making sure your fingers are well out of the way, is do your cut. With the card you might have to do a couple of passes. I think the blade's actually getting a little bit blunt on here, so this is getting ready to have a new blade in. So basically do that, and then we'll move on to the next section. Now we've got the main base wall layers cut out, we're going to put these into a stack of four and basically glue them together so that they're laminated, and this gives the model strength. So this is where the Row Kit card glue comes in. Now it does say in the instructions to use like a square with a block or an engineer square. I tend to kind of do it freehand, but it's whichever way you find easiest. So with the Row Kit glue, let's just put a bit on. You don't need much of this stuff. So I just tend to put a couple of beads on. And then very carefully lining up, make sure that all your edges are nice and square. Glue the two pieces together. That looks all nice and square to me. And we'll now add the other two pieces. It's just a case of pressing down . Make sure it's all firm stuck. Now you could leave it for a little while with just some heavy weights on, just to make sure it firmly sticks, but this Rokit car glue tends to grab pretty quick, so yeah, I would highly recommend that. The next job is to now cut out the end wall base layer sections, and again, like the main wall base layer, you need to laminate these into a stack of three. So it's this, this, and this piece here that you need to cut out. So having cut out your end wall base layer pieces here, you'll notice that on one of them you've got a rectangle with remove. Well, this is going to form the aperture or the recess for your door, and this one has to sit on top. So basically when you glue this stack together, you obviously make sure that one's on top. So once all three are glued together, you then cut out this rectangle and the style of Blue Peter. Here's one I've done earlier. So you get the nice recess here. So when you do the textured wrap layer, that the door wrap here, that will sit behind. And the end wall wrap, which is this one here, this will go over the top. And with the X that you can see here that you cut out, like when you do wallpapering in your house, around like the lights, switches and stuff like that, you do your two cuts, and they will then wrap and fold around each of the sides here. The next job is now to cut up the column base layers, and these are clearly marked, as you can see here, here, and here. So what you'll do is cut out one set of three and glue them into a stack of three, and the same again here. Cut these three out, glue into a stack of three, and cut these three out and glue into a stack of three. So here we are, we now have the three column base layers cut out and glued into stacks of three, and these will go on the side of the building. Now the next job, we'll just put this to one side, is to cut out the two roof base layers, which is this section here, this section here, and again the same as like with the column and the wall base layers, is to glue them into a stack of two. So we'll do that next. So we've now cut out the two roof base layers. And we've glued these together, so they're now laminated. Now, according to the instructions, the next thing is to cut out the base layers for the air conditioning units. Well, I'm now going to jump ahead to the first of the textured wrap layer stages, and we'll come back to the air conditioning units a little bit later on in this video. So we now move on to the main wall base layer textured wrap sheet. And it's this section here now that we're going to cut out, and you basically cut this all out as one, don't cut it into three here, because these sections here will be for the column base layers to give it the 3D effect. So again, using your steel rule and your craft knife, just carefully line it up on the edge and cut through. So now we've cut out the main wall base layer texture sheet, we're now going to place it onto the base layer. So again, out with the old glue stick, I put a nice layer of glue on here, make sure you're getting all the corners along the edges. Having got all the glue layer on now, we very carefully lay this over the top and making sure that we get all the edges nice and square. And no air bubbles. Then just gently move the texture sheet down. So the next thing now will be that we'll move on to the end section here to place the end wall base layer with the end door wrap and then the textured brick layer. So we've now cut out the end door wrap. Now at this point here you can cut out any of the different coloured doors. If you don't fancy the green one, just add a bit of variety. So if you're building a long row of these, you can have various different coloured doors to get a bit of variety. Now what I've done is I've already pre-glued sticked this area here, so now we're going to put the end door wrap texture sheet on. So we'll just carefully line that up to the edge. And smooth that down. So now that's on there, once we get the textured brick wrap layer on here, you'll see that goes on there. So moving on to the other textured wrap sheet, the next one you need to cut out is the end wall wrap section to go on this piece here. And with that X there, that is the recess for the doorway. This one and this one for your two columns in the centre here, and then your end column wrap with the longer side here obviously goes on this end here, and with the longer wall bit there we'll wrap round the edge there. So now we'll cut out this section here. Having cut out the end wall door wrap texture layer, it's a case of now cutting out the door recess. Now the other thing of note, and I don't know if the camera's going to be able to pick this out, if you can just about see there in the top left hand corner, see a little white arrow pointing up, and this represents that's the top or the roof of the building. So now what we'll do is we'll cut the recess. So very carefully line up your rule along the edge. Very carefully score through, cutting along the line. That's one that side. And again, we do the other cut. There. and this then gives you your recessed pieces to fold in the door frame there. Now another little tip, well I think on, is to make it a bit easier for the folding of the brick paper, is to turn it over and on the back very carefully line your ruler up with the tip of each cut. Then what I'd do is, with the blunt edge of the blade, the back, very lightly just score between the two lines and this will give you a sharper edge to fold against, but doesn't leave any white lines like some other card kits do on the fold joints, so it looks as though the brickwork naturally goes round the corner as per the roofing. So do that on each of the four sections. So the textured wrap layer for the end wall section, as you can see here, we've already pre-cut out now the door recess. Now one of the things to note on here is on the top left hand corner here you can just about make out a white arrow, and this shows marks the top section of the wall, as you can see with the weathering that runs down the wall, and obviously with this being the bottom. On the back, what I've done is, with the base layer, after carefully lining it up with the door aperture, is that I've made sure this is nice and square and checked that it all lines up correctly with the section on here. Is with pencil I've marked either side and then have placed the ruler on here and then done this again with the back of the blade, just a gentle score mark down there for folding over. Now one of the things I'll mention at this point here is, once we glue this onto the base layer, the short side you want to wrap around on this bit here along the edge here, and this section here don't wrap it round on here, because what you'll do is stick this on here and then with the two layers you'll end up wrapping the card or the textured wrap layer round both to go around the back of the back seam here. So we've now glued the door aperture, as you can see there, and we're now going to put this on to the main base section. So using Rokit card glue, and now what we'll do is fold this round onto here. So first of all, put some more glue on. And then it's a case of now folding this over. So I put a ruler underneath for a nice sharp edge. And with some pressure across there, push down. And as you can see, now falls around the edge and gives the impression of a bigger building. So the next job after this now is with the column sections, so one for there, there and there. It's the same again using the textured brick wrap layers, so these two for that section there and this one for that section there, and again with the longer wall section that falls round on the outside wall there. So as you can see now, we've now got the two central brick columns on and the other end brick column, which you can see here we've now wrapped around the end. Now the next job is to do the roof section. So with the roof section base layer, the two that we've cut out and laminated, what we do now is to take the textured wrap sheet again and we cut out the roof wrap, and again it's a case of then gluing that round onto here before we place it onto the main building. So cutting out the textured roof wrap layer, this is what you should have. Now there's certain black lines along, which is the bits that stick out. You need to very carefully cut these back up to this point here where you can see the line, and that's your fold crease line. As I say, so you do that on each one of these. The other bit you'll need of the textured wrap sheet is these roof end wrap pieces, and these will fit in the end pieces here and here, as you'll see as we go on to the next section. So with the roof end wrap and middle wrap sections, what you do is you glue and fold them round the two longer ones over the two middle sections there, and the two shorter ones, the end sections, they go over here. So when you fold the rest of these texture sheets over, you'll get the impression of the roof sticking out there and no sort of blank cardboard bit showing on the side there. So as you can see here now, we've got the roof layer section complete with the textured wrap layer on now, and the way how it all folds on, there's virtually or no white line marks showing at all. So the next job for this now is to apply it on top of the building like so. So you can see here now the roof section is on, and it's now time to add some of the finishing touches. One being the drain pipe, the company sign, and the company sign, as you've seen earlier, you get various different names to choose from. There's the air conditioning units and the CCTV camera. So moving on to one of the optional accessories is the company sign. So I've chosen the JCB one. So again, it's a case of cut out your two base layers, glue them into a stack of two, and in the case of gluing your wrap layer, placing that on and then folding the wrap over. Now a thought that sort of come to me is that as you get a selection of different company signs, rather than gluing these onto the building, you could use something like tacky wax and temporary stick it onto the building. So if you fancy a change of company, it's just a case of pull off the building and stick on your new sign. So if you fancy a change. So as you can see here, we've now glued the sign in place, and we now move on to the other optional extras. Now the first one is the drain pipe, the downwater pipe. Now the kit includes the texture wrap sheet for this. Now what the instructions say is to cut two thin strips of card, a bit deeper than from the red arrow to just below the white line. Glue the two strips of card together so they're laminated. Then with the edge of the card, so it sits flush with the red arrow there and red arrow there, so half of it is off the card, is to glue this down and then fold the other half over using a steel ruler to keep the edge straight and glue down the other side. Once the glue has dried, is then to cut a 1.5mm deep strip across, and that form your drain pipe. Now I've deviated slightly off the instructions here, and what I've done is I found a bit of black wire in my bits box, and I've cut a bit to length and I've stuck it down on here to represent the drain pipe, as you can see there. We'll now move on to the next optional extra, which is the air conditioning units. As you can see, there's two provided. And again, like with the base layers, is that you cut out, once you've glued your template sheet onto some card, is to cut these out and is to make two stacks of eight, and then a case of then wrapping the air conditioning texture wraps around that. So I'll do that now, and I'll show you with the air conditioning units in place on the next clip to follow. Is the CCTV cameras. So this is the wrap texture layers with the body and the cowlin that goes around the outside. As you can see, it's got like was it a weathered textured finish there, and these are the base layers that you've got to cut out. Now, as it says instructions, this bit is a little bit tricky, so it's just a case of taking your time over it, and we'll see how it goes. So having cut out the three base layers and then glued them into a stack, as you can see here and here, you then cut them in half, and with the long textured wrap piece here, the circle bit that you can see there, that's the lens, the front of the camera, and the back bit is the back of the camera. You then wrap that round the stack, so you want it so it's actually the stack is laid on its side. And as you can see on this one here, that's what we've done. You can see the lens there. The next job then is to put the basically the shell over the top and sides of the camera. So we'll do that next. And there you can see is the completed CCTV camera. As I said, the kit contains two of them. One of the things that's mentioned in the kit is if you use like a pin cut down to, I think it's about 3 millimeters, something like that. So I guess sticking that in the back of the camera and then mounting it into the wall, so like a mounting bracket. So as you can see now, we've fitted the camera. We used a dressmaker's pin, cut to about 3 millimeters and bent, and the camera stuck on the back end of it. And we've also added some of the selection of health and safety signs that comes with the kit, which we put on the door there and there. So the next thing that's left to do now is basically give this a coating in matte spray varnish, just to protect it, to stop it from fading, and install it on the layout. So as you can see here, it's now installed on the layout. The next job for me to do is to add some palisade fencing along the frontier to define the border of the railway land and obviously the private land here, plus a few of the scenic details that you'd find at the back of some of these railway side buildings. Thanks for watching.